Can we praise the Lord one more time? If your confidence is hidden in Jesus, can you just lift your hands? All over this building, can we just bless the name of the Lord? Hallelujah. There's a sweet spirit of comfort in the sanctuary this morning, that he's able to do exceedingly abundantly above that we can ask or think. Ah, we worship you, Jesus. We bless you, Jesus. Worship with us as we minister in song. Lord, I place my trust and confidence in you. For Lord, I'm sure you know just what to do. So just lead me where you will, as I follow humbly still, as I place my trust and confidence in you. I know the Lord.
Lord will see me through. I the Lord will see.
As I place my trust and confidence in Him, He promised to be our guide even unto death. He will never leave us nor forsake us. He's the faithful God. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise God. I invite Brother Carlton, our choir director, to come at this time as the Faith Chapel Choir ministers. Oh, assistant choir director. What's your name? Andre Grizzle. God bless you.
Praise God. Can we just lift our hands and worship Jesus right now? Hallelujah, Jesus. You're worthy to be praised, God. Hallelujah. Just worship with us as we minister in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I've lost some good friends along life's way. Some loved ones departed in heaven to stay, but thank God I didn't lose everything. Ooh, I've lost faith in people who said they cared. In the time of my crisis, they were never there. But in my disappointment, in my season of pain, one thing never wavered, one thing could change. And I never lost my hope. Ooh. And I never lost my joy. I'm not.
Let's clap our hands unto the Lord. Let us all stand. Let us all stand. Clap your hands, all ye people. Shout at the voice of triumph. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. We'll be inviting the minister of the word today. But I'm going to ask each of us just to find your neighbor. And hold their hand and said, guard your praise with all your life. Guard your praise with all your life. Praise God. Never lost my praise. Guard your praise. Guard your testimony. Guard your praise. No compromise for praise. Praise God. Never compromise your praise for the Lord. Never compromise your testimony. Through all your testings, keep your testimony and give your praise unto Him who is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before His throne. His name is Jesus. Able to save, able to keep, able to satisfy. That's the God we serve. And there's none like Him. There's none like Him. Praise God. Praise God. We look unto the Lord for a word today. And we pray for His manservant as he comes to minister the word in the person of Brother Garfield King and the Holy Ghost. Brother King, will you come? Praise God. Let's clap our hands unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you still have your praise, let's just give Him some praise. Let's just give Him some worship. Oh God, You are worthy to be praised. Regardless of the circumstances, He's worthy. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Come on, God, your praise right now. Give it unto Him. Praise belongs to Him. Hallelujah. Praise belongs to God. Hallelujah. You are worthy to be praised. Jesus, we exalt You. You are worthy, Lord. You're the only, oh God, object worthy of our worship and our adoration. We glorify You, Jesus. Hallelujah. You are worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Can you, bless God, just turn with me in your Bibles to the book of Habakkuk, chapter 3. And I'll be reading verses from verse 17 to verse 19 inclusive. If you have found it, say praise the Lord. Amen. So please follow. Although the fig tree shall not blossom, neither shall fruit be in the vines, The labor of the olive shall fail, and the fields shall yield no meat. The flock shall be cut off from the fold, and there shall be no herd in the stalls. Yet will I rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. The Lord God is my strength, and he will make my feet like hinds' feet. And he will make me to walk upon mine high places. Bless God. Pastor Wong, can you pray?
Could you all bow your heads? Most gracious, holy and righteous art thou, O God, merciful and kind. Thy loving kindness have never failed towards us. O God, we hear your word that have been read here, Lord. And it says to us, O God, whatever the situation, whatever the condition, we should never lose our praise, that we should guard it with everything that is within us. God, we worship you here this morning. We pray that you may touch your servant, O God. Anoint him with an unction, Lord, with apostolic authority, O God, that when he minister the word, he may minister it under the unction of the anointing. God, we pray, Lord Jesus, there be receptive ears and receptive hearts to your words. We pray for the unsaved within our midst too, Lord, that they may have an understanding that which is spiritual, even to the saving of their soul, Lord, their salvation. God, have it your way, we ask these and more. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name.
Bless the Lord. You may be seated. God is worthy. I believe that God has spoken even already. From the very moment that Sister Grizzle got up to greet, God has been speaking. But you know, I just want to say, I want to speak today for a few moments on the topic, cling to God. Cling to God. Hallelujah. Can you just say it with me? Cling to God. Amen. And so Habakkuk was a prophet. And this man was a professional prophet. There are many people who prophesied and they didn't start as a prophet. Probably they were a farmer or something else. But this man from very early evidently knew his calling. And probably went to the schools of the prophet. Was trained as a prophet. Dedicated his life to living for God. To preaching the word of God, ministering unto the people of God. And you'd think that, yes, this man has the good life, living in the presence of God. But somehow Habakkuk had issues. When he looked at the society at the time, and he was a prophet in Judah, and he recognized that, bless God, the rich people, the prosperous ones were wicked. And so Habakkuk, after observing one day, he had to talk to God. Habakkuk said, you know, God, I have some questions. And let me tell you something. Whenever there is doubt in your mind, bring your questions to God. And so Habakkuk recognized that God was the one who could answer his questions. And God is the only one who can change your situation. You can tell your situation to your friend. You can tell it to your family, to your children, to your husband. Amen. Bless God. But only God can change your situation. And so therefore, if only God can change your situation, it makes sense that you go to God and you go to him first. Could somebody praise the Lord? And so Habakkuk went to God. And Habakkuk said, God, you know, I can't understand what's happening. Because the wicked prosper. The wicked are prospering in the land. And he said, God, I don't see them being judged. I don't see, hallelujah, them being punished. And so the wicked are destroying the poor. And they keep getting fatter. They keep getting more prosperous. And the righteous man can't make the grade. He said, God, something is wrong. Why is it that the people who have dedicated themselves to serving God, the people have dedicated themselves to sacrifice, to fasting, to prayer, to do without, why are they suffering? So he said, God, the wicked are prospering. He said that, guess what? The wicked, not only are they prospering, but they are not being punished. And finally, he turns and he points a finger at God and he says, God, you are doing nothing. How is it that 7 days a week I ensure that I pray 3 times a day and I fast 2 days for a week and I read the word every day and I try to humble myself and to live for God, and yet still, hallelujah, it is the wicked man who does not regard God that's prospering, and nothing will work out for me because everything I try my hands at, it seems as if I'm failing. And God, you are doing nothing. God, you seem so far. God, you seem so distant. Hallelujah. Habakkuk's issues were not different from our issues today. They're not different. Because many of us look at the nation and we see the crime and the violence. And we see the wicked people get into politics. And they are prospering. And we see the nepotism and we see the bribery. And we see all the dishonesty. And only those who are willing to cut corners will make it in business. But the righteous man who wants to serve the Lord and walk uprightly, as one politician said it, the man who plays by the rules is the man that gets shafted. Habakkuk said, God, something has to be wrong with this system. Something is wrong. Hallelujah. But guess what? God hears and he answers our prayer. And so God said, guess what, Habakkuk? Don't worry about these wicked people in your nation. Because guess what? I'm going to send the Babylonians. And they're going to destroy them. They're going to plunder them. I'm glad you can rejoice. Because Habakkuk was even more frustrated. Habakkuk was wondering, how is it that he's complaining about the wicked people in Judah? And yet God will use a more wicked people, the Babylonians, to destroy, to punish his own people. And Habakkuk just couldn't understand. Because he went on his knee and he did it. As though the Bible said, he sought the Lord early in the morning and late at night. But the answer from God was not a pleasing answer. I'm here to tell somebody, when you see God, be prepared for the answer. Ensure that you can handle the answer. Many times we will see God, and what God tells us to do, Pastor, we won't like it. You know, God has a track record in telling people these things. There's a prophet, God said to the prophet, look here, you are a prophet, Hosea. You are a man of God. You live your life holy and righteous. You know what I want you to do? I want you to go and marry a whore. Can you understand that? God said that the priests were to marry virgins. And Hosea, even though not a priest, I mean, is a man of God. And God said, guess what? Not only are you going to marry this whore, and I want you to understand, sir, she was not a prostitute, she was a whore. Because a prostitute does it for the money, but a whore does it for the love of it. So she loved sexual immorality. And God said, you're going to marry this woman. And probably Hosea thought, okay, This is not my ideal. I've always dreamed about the woman I'd have and my wedding night with my virgin. But he said, okay, probably, you know, this is what she needs to straighten her up. So she's going to marry to the man of God and she's going to walk right and thank God. But God said, not only are you going to marry her, but she's going to be unfaithful to you. She's going to go to other men, but guess what? You're going to run her down and you're going to take her back and you're going to love her still. How can one who preserve themselves for God deserve that? Another prophet preaching the word of God. And God said, look here, man. Ezekiel, I want you to go over, son. I want you to get some man. Some feces. Human feces. And I want you to eat it. You know, the other day, a few years ago, we were complaining about some fertilizers that were being used because they had, you know, it seems like one of the components was human feces. That's a fertilizer. And we're having a problem. God said, you need to eat the feces. And the man begged and said, God, please, no. And God would have heard his cry. And God said, all right, eat cow feces instead. But you can't get rid of it. After eat feces. What am I saying? The great almighty God, sometimes he will tell you to do some things that are unorthodox, that seem unhygienic, that defy tradition. This is not our culture. This is not the way we do it. But if God says it, then you must do it. If God says it, then you must do it. I don't think he got any salsa sauce and any, you know, ketchup and that sort of thing to nice it up. Bless God. But he had to do God's will. And so, when the Lord told Habakkuk that, hey, guess what? I'm going to carry the Babylonians and they are going to punish those who are in the land and who are wicked. And guess what? Habakkuk, and this is what I want you to understand now, and this is how the book ends. When Habakkuk went back to God, he thought that Habakkuk would seek again and get a nice response, and God said, okay, I'm not going to do that. But Habakkuk recognized that this is the great almighty God. And the next time Habakkuk went back to God, he began to praise and worship. And he began to say, God, you do this and you do that. You are the one who called the mountains out of the sea. You are the one that created the heavens and the earth. You are the one, almighty God, who caused the world to spin. Hallelujah. No man can do this. So guess what, God? He said, guess what? Regardless of what happens, I don't understand and I don't necessarily agree, mighty God. But guess what? Bless God. He said, behold, hallelujah, the Lord thy God. He said, hallelujah, although the fig tree shall not blossom. Guess what, God? I don't understand. I don't understand what you're doing. And it seems unjust to me. And it seems unfair to me. And you have not given me an answer to satisfy me. But guess what? I recognize who you are. So though the fig tree will not blossom, guess what? I'm going to praise you. Though I don't understand, I'm going to worship you. Though I'm perplexed by what you're going to do, I'm going to lie prostrate before you. Because you are God and God alone, and I am just a man. And so we said, hallelujah, bless God. Neither shall fruit be in the vine, the labor of the olive shall fail, and the field shall yield no meat. The flock shall be cut off from the fold, and there shall be no herd in the stall. I know that some of you, there's no herd in the stall. There's no food in the cupboard. You have no job. You have nowhere to live. And you thought that when you decided to serve God, it would be easy. It would be cheese. Life would be good. But guess what? Hallelujah. Some things are happening that you don't understand, because you are being persecuted, you are being pursued by the enemy, and you feel as if you're under the foot of the enemy, and you feel as if you're being crushed, and you're saying things were better when I was in the world. But I'm saying to somebody, change your mindset and change your thinking and decide to cling to God, comes what may. So though the fig tree not bringing any blossom, I know you go to your bed hungry, I know you have to run from the gunman. Say like Habakkuk, he said, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. Somebody needs to rejoice in the Lord, regardless of your situation, regardless of your trial. Begin to rejoice. Somebody get up on your feet and begin to worship God. Give him a yet praise. Give him a yet praise. Give him an in spite of praise. Because God is good and his mercies endure forever. His truth endureth to all generation. He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be exalted. Come somebody magnify God with me. Let us exalt his name together. Rejoice in the Lord. Cry out and shout, the inhabitant of Zion. Cry out and shout, the inhabitant of Faith Chapel. For great is the Holy One of Israel in the midst of thee. Hallelujah. I feel Jesus in this place. I feel God in this place. I feel God in this place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I can't answer all your questions. Pastor can't answer all your questions. And some answers you'll never get until you see Jesus face to face. But you still have a responsibility to trust him, to worship him, to glorify him. Come on, lift your hands and shout Jesus. So guess what? Habakkuk's name means one who clings. That's what Habakkuk's name means. It means one who clings, or one who embraces. And so Habakkuk decided that, guess what? Regardless of the situation, I'm going to cling to God. I'm going to embrace God. I'm not going to let him go. For though he slay me, yet will I trust him. Somebody need to cling to God. Somebody need to embrace God. Somebody need to hold on to God. Regardless of your situation, regardless of what's happening, hold on to him and never let go. The woman with the issue of blood said, if I can catch him of his garment, if I can cling to it, if I can cling to it and never let it go, I know I'll be made whole. Do you want to be made whole? Just cling to Jesus this morning. If you want your deliverance, just embrace him this morning. If you want your breakthrough, just worship him. Jesus, you're worthy. Let me tell somebody, as I'm coming down, notice, God is still on the throne. God is still on the throne. God is still on the throne. God is still in control. God is still in charge. God still rules. He directs the heart of the king, and he rules in the kingdom of man. When God opens the door, tell me who can shut it. And when he shuts the door, who can open it? Many are the intentions of a man's heart, but it is God that decides his direction. It is God that decides the way that he goes. Don't worry about the wicked. God is slow to wrath, but iniquity will be punished.
I'm here to tell the wicked man iniquity will be punished. Hallelujah. You don't need to worry about those who persecute you. Because if they don't repent, iniquity will be punished. They will not escape. The Bible says that one day every man shall stand before God, great and small, and they shall answer for all the wrongs that they have done. So don't worry about the wicked who seem to prosper. Just remember their end. Just look in the book of Revelation and remember their end and begin to pity them and begin to pray for them. Don't worry about the wicked. Don't let them turn you aside. No sickness may rock your body. Somebody needs to trust God. And I'm coming down. Because guess what? God is the worthiest object of our faith. And I'm here to tell somebody that the righteous will trust God at all times. The righteous will trust God at all times. Be encouraging your soul, somebody. Cling to Him. Cling to Jesus. Don't let go. Cling to Him. Hallelujah, Marvin. Cling to Him. And I know it's rough for new converts. When you come into this walk and you don't understand, hallelujah, but I'll just leave you. The scripture says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not unto thine own understanding. Don't trust what you know. Don't trust your knowledge. Don't trust what the world tells you. But in all your ways, acknowledge Him and He shall direct your path. So if He directs you through the water, they shall not overflow you. If He directs you through the fire, you shall not be burnt. Wherever He leads you, He's there to protect you. Though He leads you through the valley of the shadow of death, you don't need to fear evil. Because He's with you. His rod and His staff, let them comfort you. Let His rod and His staff comfort you. Is there somebody who wants to embrace God this morning? You're going through this life, a godless life, facing all your problems and your trials by yourself. If you're here and you're not saved, or whether you are saved, and you want to embrace God this morning, I'm opening these altars and I'm saying, come to Him. As Sister Grizzle said, no matter what, never let go of God, saints. Never let go of Him. And if you have not been clinging to Him as yet, today is the day when you can hold on to the hem of His garments. God richly bless you. In Jesus' name.
Can we all stand right now? The altars are open right now. You need to refresh yourself. Saints of the Most High God, the altars are open. Unsaved friend, you need baptism of the Holy Ghost. You need to be baptized in Jesus' name. There's the pool, nothing hindering you today, only yourself. Salvation has come to your soul this day. Praise God. Praise God. As they're coming, we're going to ask the choral. Oh, they're already here. They're going to be ministering. We're going to be closing in prayer. For those that cannot stay, we do understand. But if you can spend some time, we're going to ask you to spend some time in His presence. There are questions that you are asking Him, and there are answers that await you. As the minister said, there may be the answers that we may not be acceptable to us, but they are the answers that God gave. If we can come to that place, though the blossom may never bloom, and though the vineyard may never give, that doesn't stop us from giving our praise, our worship. Let us bow our head. Great God, Holy Father, You have spoken unto us, O God. In no uncertain way, O God, this afternoon. We pray, O God, that You may comfort our hearts, that You grant us the consolation that we look forward to, Lord Jesus. Strengthen us and renew us, Lord Jesus, we pray. We pray for the unsaved in our midst also, O God. They are looking for an answer, O God. We pray, O God, that they may commit their life in conviction of the word that they have heard, Lord Jesus, to submit to You, O God. Lord, we pray, Lord Jesus, for those that have just gotten saved, oh God, the new convert, that you may set your holy angel to encamp it round about them, oh God. Cover them under your blood, Lord Jesus. Keep them safely in your arms, Lord. Have your way, O God, in preserving them, Lord Jesus, we pray. Comfort the hearts, Lord, that are here. Strengthen them, O God. We ask these or more in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah. Praise Jehovah. Lord God Almighty, praise Jehovah, everlasting King, we praise your name, we praise your name, Jehovah. Jehovah, we praise you, Jehovah. Lord. raise our hands and worship God all over this building right now. Hallelujah, your Savior, Lord and God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We love you, Lord. We worship you, Jesus. We love you.
We love you.
And we worship.
We worship.
Oh, we praise you.
We praise you.
Oh, we praise you.
We praise you.
And we lift you.
We lift you.
We lift you.
We lift you.
Oh, we lift you.
We lift you.
Holy Ghost.